जिंदगी में मनी नंबर इज एवरीथिंग, बट पीसीबी की सैलरी इज हायर देन सीएसएफ सैलरीज एंड स्लाइटली लोअर देन मल्टीनेशनल.
Do you see all the things, job satisfaction and all that stuff?
I would say कि मैं example देता हूँ. मुझे recently ये भी offer हुई थी private गाड़े से double salary. तो मैंने कहा pay क्यों नहीं कर सकते. तो let's say जो मेरी भी salary है वो मुझे कहीं और double salary मिल जाएगी.
Salary बात नहीं है. So, I have motive, you want to achieve.
अच्छा कि मुझे क्या चीज़ motivate करती है PCB में काम करने से?
Salary तो कुछ नहीं है. Lumps क्या होता है? क्या PT trainer आपको लगा रहा है?
So if you look in here,
PCB की salary I would say is closer to the private sector, but also much higher than CSE sector. But उसमें तो बहुत ज़्यादा होते हैं. मेरा motivation factor is again मुझे मैं उनसे बात कर रहा था. It's like कि मैं क्या बेहतरी ला सोसाइटी में, क्या बेहतरी है. जैसे मुझे एक सेटिस्फेक्शन है जब एक गरीब बच्चा जो है वो क्रिकेट खेलता है और उसका उसको उससे कोई रोजगार मिलने का जरिया बनता है. इसके अलावा सिस्टम में वो बेहतरी आती है. जैसे कि लंग्स का सिस्टम है कि जो बच्चा अच्छा परफॉर्म करता है उसका ए आता है और जो अच्छा नहीं करता उसका सी या डी आता है. तो वो उस सिस्टम में कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करना है कि जो अच्छा क्रिकेटर है वो ऊपर आए और बाकी चीज़ें ना आए. तो उसमें मुझे सेटिस्फेक्शन मिलती है कि सिस्टम की बेहतरी में. और एक वाहिद वन ऑफ द फ्यू थिंग्स है जिसकी वजह से पाकिस्तान के लोग यूनाइट हो जाते हैं. मैं एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ कि मुझे अब कॉल आई फाटा रीजन से किसी बंदे की जिस जो कि वहाँ पे क्रिकेट रन कर रहा है. वो उसका कोई मसला है क्लब क्रिकेट में कि वो फोन करेगा कि हमने आपसे बात करनी थी और हमने आपको कहना था कि ये मसला है. तो वो इतनी मासूमियत से लोग पैशनेट हैं क्रिकेट के बारे में और इतनी चीज़ें हैं जो कि आप बेहतर कर सकते हैं.
You know, while I was coming over here, I was thinking, how should I start? You know, I was like, I'm addressing people, I'm talking about my cricketing journey. And as cliched as it sounds, it's true that cricket is my passion. I grew up in a household of five boys, typical joint family system. And mujhe yaad hai ki every time there was a cricket match, it would be like a festive atmosphere within the house, as is the case with most of us, you know, cricket-loving families. But the difference was that I was the only girl, so there was a natural influence with all my cousins and my family in regards to loving the sport. My father was a cricketer. A lot of people don't know that. He did not play at an international level, but he played at a domestic level. And he was a leg spinner. And my mother, she used to write on cricket. She's covered the 99 World Cup for Dawn Herald. So I think it was in my genes, somewhat, because a lot of people ask me this question, you know, ladki ho ke aapko kis tarah cricket karna shauk hai. So it's because of that. Obviously, my parents were into it. The environment that I got growing up was such that I had to fall in love with the sport. I mean, growing up, normally, when friends would meet, they would be sitting, but I would just be watching the match. Us waqt ESPN ka ek blog hota tha, so I used to go on to the ESPN blog and I used to be starting to discuss whatever's happening in the match. And I realized that it was something which was very different, because when you go to an all-girls school, I went to convent, then I went to LGS, you didn't really see that over there. You know, nobody would be aware of ki match bhi ho raha hai shayad. So I was always into it. I used to read articles. For those of you who follow cricket, obviously you would know about Usman Samiuddin. Main cricket ko bacha ke uske sare articles padhti thi. And anything related to cricket, I would just basically follow that. I clearly remember my mother telling me that she recalls this experience ki mera exam tha agle din. I was in year 7 or something. And my parent ke Pakistan versus Bangladesh ka match dekh rahi thi. And she was like, what are you doing? You know, you have an exam tomorrow and you're watching a match. So that's how crazy I was, even from a young age. People who are close to me, they know this about myself. Ke it's not something that I've discovered within the 2 years that I've started my career. It's something that's always been there. Then from there, I went to Aston University in Birmingham, where I did my bachelor's degree in business and sociology. And beech mein maine ek saal kaam kiya at Caterpillar, the engineering firm. I'm sure all of you know about it. And I did a marketing, I worked as a marketing coordinator. And I absolutely hated it. You know, it was a typical 9-to-5 job. And I had an extremely racist boss. I was the only Asian in that all-white community. And, you know, it was just, I just woke up one day and I was thinking, is this what I'm going to be doing for the rest of my life? That I'm going to be waking up at 8 o'clock in the morning, going to work, and then coming home. And I realized that I'm not really cut for the corporate setup. I always had a very creative flair to myself. And so I started doing, at that time, I started doing makeup. And that was my hobby, so beside, you know, side pe main saath saath wo kar rahi thi. Then I did my master's from University of Warwick in marketing. And I know that none of this has any link to what I'm doing now, but this is exactly what happens. This is the point of the talk today, that sometimes in life, whatever you plan, it doesn't really go according to that. At that time, I did not even think that I would be in this field. I was passionate about it, but I was like, you know, whatever. So then I did my master's, then I worked for 2 years at Harrods. I was doing my makeup side too. I was very passionate about that as well at that point, and I thought, achha, maine yehi karna hai. Because I, like I said, I was always very creative. So I come back from England after 2 years, and I was like, okay, I'm at that stage of my life where I need to decide what I'm going to be doing with my career. And I thought that my career is going to be in makeup. Because of the fact that I did it over there, I did a couple of courses, I did London Fashion Week. I came home and I started, you know, I opened a studio and my business started doing really well. As you know, in Pakistan, there is a huge market for brides and party makeup, and I was making money and I was doing everything else. I would say, you know, happy. And then my life changed. 2015 World Cup arrived. I Australia mein jo hua tha, and I remember I was really excited about it, and I was like, I need to contribute somehow. I don't care how, I want to either write or I want to do something. And us waqt I found out ki ji duniya TV mein ek opening hai of, you know, something cricket related, and I decided to go. I mean, it was an interview, so I just went with a very nonchalant attitude, thinking that why would they offer me? I have no experience in front of the camera. I have no idea how media works. I had no media background at all. So I literally went casually and I sat over there, and I remember the programming head, he was sitting there and he said to me, "Acha, aapko cricket pasand hai?" Maine kaha, "Ji." "Wo to har ladki ko pasand hoti." And I was like, "Ji, pasand to har ladki ko hoti hai, lekin mujhe shayad zyada pasand hai." And then he was like, he said to me, "Acha, so what is reverse swing?" And I looked at him and I smiled because I knew that he was trying to test me. So I was obviously nice enough and I was like, you know, when the ball gets old, la 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 la, pura minus explain, can he say, "Acha." Then he introduced me to my boss, basically, who was very supportive, and he told me that, you know, "Let's try you out. Why don't you come, why don't you prepare this topic, and why don't you come for a mock trial in the studio, like in front of the camera, like we'll do a mock trial as if you're going live on air." And the topic was Patani India ka squad or something. And every day for 10 days, they were like, you have to basically prepare something. And first day I walk in, they take me into the studio, mera makeup ho raha hai, hair ho raha hai, mujhe ankles ki tarah itne bade bade mujhe baal bana diye, jis tarah hamare hote hain. You know, they made me look really horrendous. And I obviously, it was, you know, it was part of it. So I was like, no, I'm going to be focused. That went really well because there was a person sitting there. And by the way, it's not as easy as it seems. You know, you're watching it on the screen and it looks like a small studio and you're sweating and you're talking. But it's actually quite intimidating because you walk into the set, onto the set, and you're sitting in the studio and you have these like thousands of lights on your face. It was intimidating, I have to admit, and I was nervous. But I got over it because I was like, I had knowledge, thankfully, so I was obviously using that. And for the 10 days, I did mocks, and uske baad they were like, my boss said to me, he's like, no, we're impressed with you and we want you to do a World Cup show and sit in the panel. So not as an anchor, which I am right now, but sit in the panel. And guess who was with me in the panel, sitting with you, live show? Saeed Ajmal and Imran Azim. And Saeed Ajmal, by the way, at that time was, you know, right at its on his peak. I mean, in the sense that he was banned, but like, he was the best spinner that you had within the country. So I was like, obviously taken aback and completely overwhelmed ke, you know, how what's happening to me in dam se to. Fair, anyway, we started with the show, and I still remember my first show, which was live. I was extremely giggly, and it was funny in a way, because I was, obviously, I had this nervous energy about me. But I managed to do it fine. And then it's just like anything else, that you know, you face the camera and you get familiar with an environment and then you become okay with it. So I did that. And then I remember that India-Pakistan ka match tha on the 15th of February. And obviously we had to do a show and everything. And my studio was waiting and I started feeling sick. So I started feeling sick and I was like, I thought it's minor, koi mujhe temperature ho gaya ya fever hai or something. And I go home and I started throwing up. You know, I was vomiting and I was in a really bad state. And mujhe samajh nahi aa rahi thi ki mere sath ho kya raha hai. I went, I got my test done and my doctor was like, ki aapko hepatitis ho gaya, hepatitis. And he's like, you are bedridden for the next 40 days. And I was like, no, that's not possible because I have to be doing my show. And he was like, no, there is no option. So I got this shock because I was like, I was in a high. People were coming and giving me feedback and they were like, oh, we've seen you, you're doing so well, or the show was doing so well. And then, ekdam se, I am in a situation where, you know, I'm like completely bedridden, I can't even walk to the bathroom. So, us waqt, obviously, I used to do it from the bed, literally, my beak was there with the phone pe. And within 2 weeks, I was back, I did that. It was a huge hit, the whole show, and they decided that we're going to hire you permanently. But my boss said to me that you can't sit as an expert because there's no career progression, you have to become an anchor. And initially, I completely refused because I was like, I've never faced a camera in my life and you want me to drive a whole show. And he was like, no, we'll train you, blah, 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 all of those things. And then the other problem that I faced, well, I knew that I would face that, is that when you're doing a show, obviously they give you a talk back. So you're listening to the producer, what all his instructions, ke ji, break le, ye kare, wo kare, and it's completely chaotic. It looks like on TV, it looks very nice, but it's actually very chaotic because there are a million and one instructions going on. So my issue was, or is, that I'm completely deaf from my left ear. I cannot hear anything. And I mentioned this to him at that point, that how am I going to conduct a show jisme main ek ear mein earpiece laga rahi hu and I have to listen to the guest. So how am I going to manage that? But I was so determined and I was so, I really wanted to, I was like, I'm just going to overcome it, whatever, I'll manage. So I used to put my earpiece and I put thoda sa isko dheela rakhti thi so that I could hear what the guest is saying. And it was very tough, especially when you're doing it in the crowd or peeche crowd hota hai, to kuch samajh nahi aa rahi hoti. And a lot of times I don't even understand the question and I'm just like, sometimes, but you get the hang of it. You know, you get the hang of it and you get used to it. But that taught me one thing, that, you know, even if there is a certain physical disability or any kind of problem that you face, you can overcome it. It's not a big deal and nothing is impossible. As cliche as it sounds, it's actually very true. So I started training to become a co-anchor. From a co-anchor, I trained and I remember they were like, now you know you're confident enough to do your own show. So we'll give you a solo show, which is called Cricket Diwani. And aap uski training start kare. Maine training start ki, mera mock hua, और एक दिन मैं बैठी हुई थी दे वर लाइक यू हैव टू रीड अ स्कोर कार्ड और समथिंग यू नॉर्मली रीड इट ऑफ द प्रॉम्प्टर इट इज देयर बट आई नेवर यूज अ प्रॉम्प्टर बिकॉज़ आई वाज लाइक आई कांट रीड एक तो माय उर्दू रीडिंग स्किल्स आर नॉट दैट ग्रेट एंड दूसरा आई वाज लाइक आई एम जस्ट गोना स्पीक नेचुरली बिकॉज़ दैट्स व्हाट आई एम बेटर एट सो वन डे दे वर लाइक यू नो टेलिंग मी दे गेव मी द क्यू एंड आई जस्ट स्टॉप टॉकिंग लाइक आई फ्रोज लिटरली द स्क्रीन इज देयर थैंकफुली इट वाजंट ऑन एयर बट इट वाज लाइव ऑन एयर I completely froze and I was looking at the camera and they were telling me you know, that I speak and meri awaaz nahi nikal rahi thi because I was so nervous and I thought after that this is it this is the end of my career I'm never going to come back and I will never be able to do this again I remember I went home I was very upset with my mother I was telling her I was like oh I'm never going to do this I can't do it you know I'm not confident enough and this and that and she's like you know just calm down and practice it Anyway, again, I just pulled myself together and went back. I practiced it. Then I had a couple of shows. I started doing shows. And then in between, I interviewed everybody, all the cricketers that you can name. They were all guests on my show. So that issue where you feel that you're a little starstruck or whatever, it goes. Because when you're in the profession, all you're thinking about is your job. Nothing else comes to your mind. Then I got the opportunity to interview Imran Khan, which I think was a huge thing. And that was, by the way, 2 days after his divorce with Riya. So I was a little nervous as to how that would go as well. But it was quite an experience. I went to Bani Gala, and this was a completely sports-related interview. It had nothing to do with politics, and I think that's why he agreed as well. And I remember I sat over there and, you know, he walked in and he definitely has this aura around him. I mean, whatever it is, we might all have our political differences, but when he walks in the room, you know that he's walked in the room. So, I interviewed him and uske baad I felt ke ab main kisi ko bhi interview kar sakti hu. Because if you can interview him, somebody who's got such a strong personality, then it doesn't make a difference if you're doing an international star or, you know, whoever. So that was, I felt, where my career started to really take off. And then PSL happened. Again, it was something at that time, pata nahi tha ki jee, karor dafa news aaye ki PSL is going to happen, PSL is not happening. You remember that how many times it was like, we're going to go through with it, and then it was like, nahi ho raha. There was always this confusion around whether it's going to happen or not. But it happened, and I got an offer from them to host it. And at that time, honestly speaking, I had no idea how big it's going to be. You know, anyone who follows cricket would know that it's huge. So I'd never done something like that. I was working with a different production team, international production team. I had to switch my medium from Urdu to completely English because it was all in English. And I remember I did my first show and I received a lot of criticism. You know, I was you know, there's this concept which is called cyberbullying. And it actually exists. You know, if I'm on my Twitter, on my Facebook, I started receiving comments that, you know, ye kal ki ladki kahan se aa gayi, ye wo, she doesn't know anything. And they just have to keep them because they're women. So, you know, that's why they need a woman over there. And I received such nasty comments over there. And some of it was right as well. You know, some of it was constructive criticism, but a lot of it was just trolling. And I got really affected at that point because I came home and I spoke to my mother and I was like, you know, all these people are like, passing all these negative comments. But again, the thing with me at least was that I'm a quick learner. So I put myself together, went back, started practicing in front of the camera or whatever. And then, you know, PSL finished, and which I thought was amazing. But in this whole journey, all these challenges that I faced, one of the other things was that some of our cricketers, which I'm not going to name, I don't believe in naming and shaming, some of the religious clout that you have, they actually were like that, humne aapke saath show nahi karna. Kyun nahi karna? Because you're a woman, you know. Literally, it was literally that. I don't want to name them. But you can imagine there is that cloud, so it's one of them. It's like, हमने अगर डरना भी है तो हम दूर बैठेंगे और पता नहीं क्या हाँ क्या मतलब आपके साथ सेट पे नहीं बैठेंगे एंड वी आर गोना मेक आई कांटेक्ट विद यू एंड यू नो स्टफ लाइक दैट सो आई हैड टू डील विद इट इन अ वेरी डिप्लोमेटिक वे बिकॉज दैट वाज ऑब्वियसली देयर बट देन उसके बाद आई डिड इंटरनेशनल टूर्स आई डिड जस्ट द इंग्लैंड टूर दैट पाकिस्तान वन वेल वी ड्रू द सीरीज ओवर देयर आई वाज 5 वीक्स इन इंग्लैंड Traveling around, reporting from there. Then I went to Australia, I went to Melbourne, Sydney, and I was in Dubai. So now I'm like not here basically half the year, which is the amazing part of my job that you get to travel a lot. But the kind of exposure and the amount I learned by going abroad and traveling, it was amazing because I got to meet all those journalists that I've always, you know, read about in my life. Australia maybe and cricket focus are more and generally as well the kind of things that you learn from them so it was amazing in that regard and then obviously I did PSL2 bhi maine bhi kiya which usme I felt because I'd done it once so I was more familiar with how it works and I was a lot better although I still got like mujhe literally you know Twitter pe comments aa rahe hote hain people feel the need to tell you how to dress up even So they'll be like, yeah, aapne ankles apni cover nahi ki hui, baji dupatta le lo. You know, literally, I get that a lot. Baji, aapne dupatta le lo. Stuff like that. I literally get that a lot. But at the end of the day, it comes to a point where you just filter all the negative information. You get used to it so much. And I'm not just trying to portray a negative image. 80% of the things that I get are positive as well. That, you know, you're doing a great job, blah, blah, blah. But you will get a lot of people who are hating on you and people who are jealous of you. I mean, that is something that, you know, jealousy exists in every field. And especially professional jealousy is very much there. Like when I was working, I did encounter it. I had co-anchors who were backbiting and trying to pull my leg somehow and trying to put me down. So these are all the problems that were there and I sort of faced. But I overcame them, and that is mainly because of one reason, because of the fact that I love what I do. And that is the whole point of today, that, you know, it is a cliche, but they say that you should follow your passion, and that's exactly what I did. I could have been stuck doing a corporate job. Yes, it is something that was different, something that my family initially They were quite supportive, but there were a few eyeballs ki achha media mein kaam karegi bahut hi buri ladki hai you know that typical reaction that you get within our society but the fact of the matter is that I love what I do and to everyone here that's what I want to say as well that whatever you do just remember that there are no shortcuts in life you will have to work very hard you will need to be slightly lucky you will need to overcome a lot of challenges But you will get there. Yeah. So. Questions. Yeah.
So sorry, but it's gonna come off as very gender oriented. So, so you mentioned that you used to get a lot of comments about your appearance, for instance, right? Were there any particular obstacles that you might have faced just because of your gender? That you were working in, I'm assuming, in a male-dominated field.
See, the thing is that it is true. You do see, like I told you, I used to get a few comments like that as well. KG, she's just a girl. What would she know about cricket or something like that? Then you do get that. You do get the odd comment. But then you have to stop thinking about what every third person is saying. No, वो जो है ना लोग क्या कहेंगे वो दैट पार्ट यू हैव टू डिलीट आउट ऑफ योर करियर कंप्लीटली बिकॉज़ इफ यू स्टार्ट वरिंग अबाउट दैट देन हाउ यू गोना लेट देम से व्हाटएवर दे हैव टू से बट थैंकफुली इन टर्म्स ऑफ माय ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आई वाज लकी बिकॉज़ दे वर वेरी सपोर्टिव आई नेवर फेस्ड दिस इशू फ्रॉम डे 1 आई डिड वॉक इनटू अ लॉट ऑफ मेन इन द न्यूज रूम एंड आई गॉट अ कल्चरल शॉक बिकॉज़ आई वाजंट एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट बट I got over it and I mean I think because of the support that I had from my boss in particular, it really did help me out. Yeah.
very good question. I think is the typical answer, but it is actually true, that you need to make your domestic structure stronger. You look at all around the world, you look at Australia, Sheffield Shield, you look at all the countries, even India now, you know, they've got better facilities, they've got better grounds, the balls that they use over there are much better. Hamara jo ball ki condition hai, wo bhi is grazed ball ki hoti hai. We should be using Duke, Wakar Yunus was saying the other day. So, जो नीचे आप बोगे वो ही आगे आपको उस तरह से आएगा तो until unless you don't address your roots you will always have these problems. I mean we talk about why we don't get good batsmen, why don't we get good batsmen? Because the pitches that you prepare in domestic are all bowler friendly. The pindi में चले जाओ आप कहीं भी चले जाओ medium paces आपके अब क्यों निकल रहे? Because they all have these green tops where they bowl and they get wickets. So it's not something that can be changed overnight. I mean, Pakistan is super talented. Everybody knows that. We have seen so many talents come through and so many talents go down. And that is one of the reasons because jo aapka niche hai, we talk about grooming and stuff, wo bhi niche level se hoti hai. But in our system, it doesn't exist. So the domestic is something that needs to be worked on. Working with him because I don't have to tell him much. You know, some of the cricketers you have to tell them. They don't know, like you have to prepare them a little. But I really enjoyed doing the show with him. Who else? Misbah is good. Like Misbah is always good because he's very correct always. But I think in terms of fun, Saeed Ajmal, because he belongs to Faisalabad and uski wo bilkul jo Faisalabad typical jugat maarne wala style jo hai wo hai. So he was a lot of fun.
Misbah likes him as well. वो कहता है कि dressing room का माहौल बहुत अच्छा लगता है. सही दर्शन का आप motivated रहते हो.
Yeah. Yeah. Selected for the World Cup and some of the selection was really questionable. There was a lot of bias and Sifarish, you know, it works within our system. A lot of the deserving girls did not get selected. For example, Anna Amin, she was dropped on the basis of her fitness, but she was actually the best left-arm spinner that Pakistan had. She was named in the World T20, ICC World 11 as well. So, no proper structure. And again, they're not up jaake, they're given media exposure. Pehle to you probably, most of us didn't even know ke, ki captain kaun hai, but because of the exposure that they've got, aista it's becoming and again, structure. The structure at the bottom is what really needs to be changed.
Thoda sa, I would like to add a political or religious part to what you say, but thoda sa very religious feel. ये नहीं कर सकते ये गेम आप नहीं खेल सकते हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ क्रिकेट पीस कदाफी स्टेडियम के साथ जो लोहार रीजन का है ग्राउंड एलसीसीए वहां पे वुमेन क्रिकेट का मैच हो तो वो आ जाते हैं कि भाई ये क्रिकेट नहीं खेल सकती है अलाउड नहीं है तो आई थिंक ये भी थोड़ा सा हर्डल है कि जो वुमेन क्रिकेटर्स हैं ज्यादातर वो यूनिवर्सिटी से आ रहे हैं आई थिंक अगर ये रिलीजियस बैरियर ना हो तो
really does uplift the spirit of everybody around him.
moment, I would say.
Yes? What are your thoughts on Miss by 99 twice?
Getting out of 99?
Yes.
Yeah, it's, I think he's probably the unluckiest captain in
Unluckiest record as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's really sad because it is his last series, and how many times do you get to hear that he got out of 99 twice? But it is unfortunate, but at the same time, Misbah is Misbah. Even if it was one short of a century, the amount that he's done for Pakistan cricket, it's amazing. Considering how we started, we were in turmoil with all the fixing saga, and the way he's pulled the team together.
From number 7, 8 to number 1, I think, big achievement.
Yeah, and once in a bump, it's 650 hours, recently. But, like, I mean, in the sense that credit where the team.
Have you had any experiences like the one the Australian reporter had with Chris Gayle, where he was like, would you go out with
nothing
him?
Like. I would actually, this happened in January last year,
yeah.
And PSL tha, so PSL was in February.
Yeah.
So I gayi wahan pe, to then mujhe producer tha ki you have to do Chris Gayle. This was like right, us waqt this whole topic was going on. And I was very hesitant. I was like, then they changed their mind, they're like, okay, we'll get Tom Moody to do it. So Tom was, he was actually standing next to me, and at the end of the interview, he said, don't blush, Tom. I don't know if a lot of you remember, but he said, don't blush, Tom, and he was standing right there, but he is quite a character. Yeah.
Since you've met with different cricket journalists, one thing I was curious about was that on Cricket Info, I find that the standard of writing is very consistently high. I was just curious, do they have a certain internal training program, or are they able to find very high quality writers all around the world? Because the depth of knowledge historically and the quality of writing, I just find is.
I'm not sure if whether there's an internal program as such, but that is true. I mean, you get the best writers around there, and I think it's because of the fact that they've maintained a certain standard. That you get all the quality writers. At Pakistan, they see you have a lot of them who are writing, and Usman is obviously one of the best. But even from other countries, Sri Lanka, say Andrew Fernando here, then you have India, so many different goals. So they've maintained their standard, and that's why I think they're so good. I don't, to be honest, I mean, I write for Dawn occasionally, and I for the Dunya blogs that we have on our website, but I'm not a very great writer, I'm going to admit it. I can only try. I try and keep on writing so that I get better. Yeah.
And do you cover like happenings in cricket beyond Pakistan? So like the current BCCI issue with ICC on the Champions Trophy?
Yeah.
So like, I mean, do you guys cover there or like?
We talk about it in my show, or we cover it in the news. And that is anything which is related to cricket. It doesn't have to be Pakistan cricket. Anything which is related to cricket is always talked about. And this is a very hot and happening issue, because if they do pull out, so then what are the possibilities? Because uske bhi repercussions honge. I don't think they are going to buy them, because it's not going to be easy for them. ICC can easily stop IPL players from coming to IPL, then they can stop bilateral series from happening. So. And then they would be isolated. So,
that's what they said about Brexit as well.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying that it's not as easy as it sounds. Okay, they're just gonna pull out like that. Yes, they have threatened, but mujhe nahi laga. It depends. They have a different committee which they take advice from, and wo bhi recommend kar rahe hain ki nahi karna chahiye. So I don't think they will.
Hey, I quite liked the idea. Sorry, just idea. Okay, you have to find what you love. अच्छा इसमें what I realized from experience of people के लोग समझते हैं कि यार अच्छा हमको मिल गया हमें नहीं मिला. मगर इसके पीछे बहुत ज़्यादा मेहनत होती है. आप बहुत दफा fail हो के वो चीज़ achieve करते हो. The trick is the perseverance. You have to keep striving. Again, मैं बहुत छोटी example दूँ. मगर मुझसे बहुत से लोग पूछते हैं कि आपने बार बैंक स्लैब का काम किया, आप ना फिजिसिस्ट हैं ना मैथमेटिशियन है. मैं कंपनी इनकॉर्पोरेट की थी यूके में, जिसमें मैंने 95% मेहनत की और and I just worked 5% of it and it just worked. So it was my failure of 2 years that I achieved biomechanics. So again, ये जैनब की जो example है वो